Anatomy of the skull. The skull is the skeleton of the head and the face. The skull is formed of 21 fixed bones. All these bones are fixed except the mandible, which is the only movable bone of the skull. Therefore, the skull is the skeleton of the head and the face, formed of 21 fixed bones. 5 single bone and 8 paired bones. And there is only one movable bone, which is the mandible. The bones of the skull articulate together by a fibrous joint called sutures. These sutures is the joint between the bones of the skull, and actually it is a fibrous joint. And we all know that fibrous joint is a fixed joint, doesn't allow any movement. There are three important terms. First of all, cranium. The cranium means the skull, the part of the skull, enclosing and protecting the brain. Therefore, the part to surround the brain is called the cranium. Facial skeleton is the part of the skull below the orbital cavity. This is the orbital cavity containing the eyeball. The skeleton below the orbital cavity is called the facial skeleton. There is also a term called calvaria. Calvaria means the skull vault or the skull cap only. This part is called calvaria. The skull is described from outside by 5 aspects called norma. This view is anterior view from the front. Therefore, it is called norma frontalis. This view of the skull from lateral aspect called norma lateralis, etc. Therefore, there are 5 norma: norma frontalis, norma lateralis from above, norma verticalis from behind, norma occipitalis, and from below called the norma basalis, which is the base of the skull. The interior of the skull, inside the cavity inside the skull, is called cranial cavity. And the cranial cavity is never seen except after removal of the skull cap or skull vault. If you remove this part of the skull, you can see inside the skull. This is called the cranial cavity. First, we'll discuss norma verticalis. This is view to the skull from above, vertical view from above, called norma verticalis, or simply, it is a superior view of the scalp. In each norma, we should know the bones forming this view and the sutures seen in this view and special features of this view. In any norma, bones, sutures, special features. Norma verticalis, when we see the skull from above, we will see four bones. The four bones are bone present in front, because this bone in front, it is called the frontal bone. And one bone seen posteriorly, called occipital bone. In between the frontal bone in the front and the occipital bone posteriorly, in between there are two bones called two parietal bones. Therefore, when we look to the skull from above superiorly, we will see four bones: frontal, occipital, and in between there are two parietal bones. Between the four bones, there are three sutures. Suture between the frontal bone and the two parietal bone. This suture, which is called coronal suture, between the frontal and the two parietal. Posteriorly, the same. The two parietal are separated from the occipital bone by this suture, which is called lambdoid suture. Lambdoid suture. In between the two parietal bone, just in the middle line, this suture is called sagittal suture. Therefore, norma verticalis formed of four bones, three sutures. What is this? Frontal, posteriorly, occipital, in between two parietal. These are the four bones, three sutures: coronal, sagittal, lambdoid. What are the special features seen in this norma verticalis? First of all, there are two prominent areas. The most prominent areas on the frontal bone here. This and this. These are the most prominent areas on the frontal bone, called prominence means eminence. Therefore, these two are frontal eminences. Two elevations, two prominence called frontal eminence. The same here in the parietal bone. The two prominent area here. The most prominent area on the parietal bone are called parietal eminence. Therefore, there are two anterior elevation in the frontal bone called the frontal eminence. This elevation and this elevation. And in the parietal bone, there are two elevations. Parietal eminence. Here, not present in this picture. There may be a foramen called parietal foramen in the parietal bone, therefore it's parietal foramen. This parietal foramen for immature vein. What is the meaning of immature vein? The soft tissue covering the skull is called scalp. The scalp have venous drainage. And inside the skull, brain. The brain have venous drainage. The veins outside the skull, which are the veins of the scalp, are connected with the intracranial veins inside the skull, draining the brain. The veins outside the skull and the veins inside the skull are connected by veins passing through foramina in the skull. And the veins connecting the extracranial veins and the intracranial veins, these veins are called immature veins. If this foramen is present, it's called parietal immature foramen for passage of immature vein to connect the scalp veins outside the skull with the intracranial veins inside the skull. And this foramen may be absent. This is a parietal immature foramen present in this picture. On both sides of this suture, on both sides of sagittal suture. There is an important term called berigma. What is the berigma? The point of meeting between these two sutures. What is this suture? Coronal. And what is this suture? Called the sagittal. The point of meeting between coronal and sagittal suture is called berigma. Berigma. This meeting between coronal and sagittal called the berigma. What is the importance of the berigma? In this site, in the fetus, in the fetus, there is area called anterior fontanelle in this site. This is adult skull and ossification in this area occur. But during infancy and in newly born, till the age of 18 months, there is here a diamond-shaped membrane called the anterior fontanelle, which ossifies at the age of 18 months to 2 years. What is the anterior fontanelle? The picture of the anterior fontanelle is present here at the end. This is the infant skull from above. This is the norma verticalis in newly born and during infancy. Here, there is the anterior fontanelle, which is a diamond-shaped membrane. It has very important clinical points during labor to detect the position of the fetus. This is the anterior fontanelle. When ossified, it leaves a point called the berigma. Corresponding to the anterior fontanelle, which ossified later on to become the berigma, posteriorly, the sagittal suture meet the lambdoid suture. Here at this point, which is called in adult lambda, lumbar. This lumbar represents a membrane here in the fetus, and until the age of 3 months, this area called is a membrane before ossification, before 3 months of life, called posterior fontanella. Therefore, the pregma represent in the fetus before ossification anterior fontanella, and the lambda before ossification forming posterior fontanella. The anterior fontanelle ossify and disappear at the age of 18 months, while posterior fontanelle ossify and disappear at the age of 3 months. There is important point also called vertex. What is the vertex? Vertex is the highest point of the skull. Where is the highest point of the skull? In the middle of this suture. This is the sagittal suture. In the middle of the sagittal suture is called the vertex, which is the top, the highest point of the skull. We can return to adult skull. This is the norma verticalis, the point of meeting between coronal and sagittal is called the pregma. Pregma after ossification in adult life, but during infancy and intrauterine, here there is area diamond membrane called the anterior fontanelle. The point of meeting between sagittal and lambdoid suture is called lambda, and here there is a membrane forming the posterior fontanelle during fetal life and during first 3 months of life only. After 3 months, it ossify and disappear. The vertex is here, the middle of the sagittal suture. These are the norma verticalis. Thank you for good listening and good luck.